it's just, the weather's just been absolutely wonderful. I just can't find no reason to complain, it's not been so hot. We've had a few hot days, but nothing like in times past, and just love the Lord today. I'm gonna be reading out of the book of Daniel, which is the kind of Daniel. Daniel in chapter 3. Also like to take a moment and invite you to a vacation Bible school at East End General Baptist. They asked me to announce that. I was preaching for them a couple of Sundays ago. It starts, I think, tonight at 6 o'clock, and we're going through the 16th. So if you have any youngins, you want to take them on out there, I'm sure they'll enjoy it. And I'm sure they'd be glad to have you over there with the kids out of St. Joseph's Bible School this week. Every night they come in talking about the Lord. And I just appreciate the community that we live in. You know, it doesn't matter what tile's hanging over the door, but when we go in there, we feel the love of Jesus. It's just a wonderful thing to live in a community like we live in here in Scottsville. And I just would like to invite you out there. I know that there's a good church over there, and they'll accept you in with open arms and just love you to death and love the children. And you get a chance to make home over there. Also, would like to echo the same words that Brother Rogers said. I don't know how long they'll let me preach. They might not let me preach as long as they have, so I thought I'd... they might cut me off, but I thought I would invite you to the General Assembly also. I believe that you enjoy it. Some of you in here today or on the radio have never been to the General Assembly. It is something that is just absolutely wonderful, and you don't need to miss. There's just a special, I believe every service is special, but I believe that when God ordains people and they come from miles and miles around, He rewards them for that, and the sacrifice that you make to come during the middle of the week, you'll be rewarded for that. And those of you that sign up to help and help Sister Jean and Sister Mary Ellen and all those that are cooking and cleaning and driving the vans, and you'll have a reward for that, I promise you. God has blessed me every year that I've tried to sacrifice and take my vacation, whether I'm driving the van or whatever I'm doing. It's just been a reward. I mean, I don't know how you can get such enjoyment of driving people around, but it is. You know, God blesses you for that. We'll get to singing in that van, and you get to minister to some of the missionaries. It's just a wonderful time, so we'd like to invite you, whether you go to a Baptist church or a Methodist church. We don't care. The doors are open. We'd love to have you. And that starts the 20th, as Brother Roger said, at 7 o'clock Monday night. Just love to have you here. Daniel chapter 3, if you put there, say amen. Reading out of verse 2. Then Nebuchadnezzar, the king, sent together the princes and the governors and the captains and the judges and the treasurers and the counselors and the sheriffs and all the rulers and provinces to come in the dedication of the image which Nebuchadnezzar the king had set up. Then the princes and the governors and the captains and the judges and the treasurers, the counselors, the sheriffs, and all the rulers of the provinces were gathered together under the dedication of the image that Nebuchadnezzar the king had set up. And they stood before the image that Nebuchadnezzar had set up. Brother Roger was getting on my message a little bit there, but that's all right. Then a herald cried aloud to you, "It is commanded, O people, nations, and languages, that at what time you hear the sound of the cornet, the flute, the harp, the sackbut, the psaltery, the dulcimer, and all kinds of music, you fall down and worship the golden image that Nebuchadnezzar the king had set up. And whoso falleth not down in worship shall at the same hour be cast into the midst of a burning fiery furnace. Therefore, at the time when all the people had heard the sound of the cornet, the flute, and the sackbut, and the psaltery, and all kinds of music, all the people and nations and languages fell down and worshiped the golden image that Nebuchadnezzar the king had set up. Wherefore, at the time a certain Chaldeans came in and accused the Jews. They spake and said to the king Nebuchadnezzar, O king, live forever. Thou, O king, hast made a decree, and every man that shall hear the sound of the cornet, the flute, the harp, the sackbut, the psaltery, and the dulcimer, and all kinds of music shall fall down and worship the golden image. And whosoever falleth not down and worship, that he should be cast into the midst of a burning fiery furnace. There are certain Jews whom thou hast settled in the affairs of the province of Babylon, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. These men, O king, have not regarded thee. They serve not thy God, nor worship the golden image which thou hast set up. Then Nebuchadnezzar said in his rage and fury, and commanded to bring Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. And they brought these men before the king. Nebuchadnezzar spake and said unto them, Is it true, O Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego? Do not ye serve my gods, nor worship the golden image which I have set up? Now listen here carefully. Now if ye be ready, that at what time ye hear the sound of the cornet, the flute, the harp, the sackbut, the psaltery, and the dulcimer, and all kinds of music, you fall down and worship the image which I have made. Well, but if ye worship not, ye shall be cast the same hour into the midst of the burning fiery furnace. And who is the God that shall deliver you out of my hand? Listen, he asked them a simple question. He said, Who is that God that shall deliver you out of my hand? Who is that God today? Do you know who he is? Who is it? Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego did. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego answered and said to the king, O Nebuchadnezzar, we are not careful to answer thee in this matter. In other words, they said, we ain't got to study on it. We ain't got to think about it. We know exactly who's going to deliver us today. Amen? He said, If it be so, our God, whom we serve, is able to deliver us from the burning fiery furnace, and he will deliver us out of thine hand, O king. But if not, that's what Christians today need to be saying. But if not, be it known unto thee, O king, that we will not serve thy God, nor worship the golden image that thou hast set up. Would you bow your heads with me? Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you, God, for the reading of your word. Lord, we thank you, God, for the opportunity to be able to minister. Lord, I pray that, God, you'd help us today, Father, as we come and we preach to this great audience and the audience on the radio, Lord, that, God, you'd help somebody driving down the road, Father. You'd help somebody in this church that, God, wherever they might be in their life, Father, we know that they need you. And, God, would you help us today, Father, to minister the message that you've burned on our hearts. Lord, would you help us today, Father, if there's a law, put them under conviction, Lord. Lord, if there's somebody out there with suicidal thoughts, God, I pray that you would comfort them and let them know, Lord, that that's not the way out. God, we praise you today, Father, for all that you do. Lord, help us today, Father. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray. Church would say amen.
Amen.
And the preacher would say amen. I want to preach on the topic today, My Redeemer Lives. Amen. My Redeemer Lives. Hallelujah. As they were going into this fiery furnace and the decree had been set out and the decree had been made for the prince that whatever that you was to do, whatever you were doing at that moment, you were to absolutely stop it and to bow down when you heard this music. It kind of reminds me of the Muslim faith that they have over there. They could be driving down the road. They could be driving a taxi. They could be working out in the field. And whenever that old man gets up there and they start playing that music at certain times of the day, then Muslims will bow down wherever they're at. They'll go out there and they'll bow down up and down all day long. And then they get back to work. I don't know. I guess you'd have to have a Muslim for a boss to be able to do that, I guess. But in the day and age we live in, I heard there was a factory down there that was opening up a prayer room for Muslims. That when they needed the time for them to go pray, they could go in. I thought to myself, it makes me sick to my stomach, but they won't even let a Christian bring up. Amen. You don't have to say that we need it. But I'm going to tell you today that we need as Christians to know one thing for sure.